Welcome back to another episode. I am Crystal Hughes, founder CEO of Crowned Crystals and Crystal Glaze. We're here today to talk about patterns, methods, how to even apply the rhinestones. You'll hear both terms going around. Most times I say scatter method, fill method, honeycomb method. However, many people use the term pattern, so you'll hear both. According to the dictionary, a method is a particular way of doing something in orderly arrangement. A pattern is considered a repeated decorative design. So you'll hear both. Most times I say method. So we're going to be covering the honeycomb method, the scatter method, the linear method, and the circular method. Just know that you're not alone on this journey. I too have had many, many imperfections on things that I've made in the past. I still make mistakes to this day, even though I've been doing this for a long time. This is my very first bling cup that I created for myself. This is years old. I don't carry it. I mentioned that before on, I think, my personal Instagram page. I don't carry this around because I am a bling artist. This is what I do for a living. And it's kind of embarrassing when somebody looks up closely and they see all the gaps and imperfections. But start somewhere and you will get better over time. Hopefully this video will help you to learn your preferred pattern that you like to use when applying your rhinestones. I didn't even know this was called a scatter method at the time. I just had multiple sizes of rhinestones that I used and I just started placing them all over the cup, but it had no structure. I just placed them wherever. This could have looked better. And I would have, most people would not notice as many of the mistakes on this cup had I painted the cup silver first so that the stones match the background. That makes a huge difference. And we'll look at that as well. How if you're using a rhinestone, if you're painting a pink cup and you use pink rhinestones versus if you were using a white cup and you use pink rhinestones, it's going to look totally different. So this could have looked better if the background or the base of this cup was silver, but I didn't paint it. And you can see, you can see all of the mistakes that I made. So bear with me. This is years old. There's still lots of glue on this cup. I didn't know back then that I could just take an X-Acto knife and pick that glue off, you know. Ooh, y'all, I tried. Bless my heart. Bless my achy, breaky heart. Y'all know I'm from the South, so we say bless my heart. But I did not use, you know, this is not it. However, it's still not horrible. It's still art, but I was clearly still learning. All those gaps, I didn't have enough. If I would have used more small stones, you know, it wouldn't have looked as bad. Then I had the nerve to put my, I had the nerve to put my business name at the bottom. But guess what? Most people do not notice those imperfections anyway. Ooh, look at all that glue. Look at that. Look at that. We all start somewhere. We all start somewhere. Okay. Now, at this time, I am going to first demonstrate with this Sharpie on this piece of paper the different patterns that we will cover in the video. And then later, I am going to show you with actual rhinestones how this applies when using the actual products. I'm a visual learner, so I thought I'd throw this in there first so that you can understand better. Also, please excuse all the noise in the background. I am currently traveling, but I'm so passionate about getting these videos out to you that I wanted to release this video a little early. So I'm sitting at the airport, and so the background noise that you hear is because I'm at the airport. Forgive me. A win is a win. A win is a win, right? Baby, I tried.
As you can see, I was trying to do you a circular pattern, but I didn't leave enough room in the middle to really show you what I mean by this. So we're gonna scratch that out. We're gonna try again. I crack myself up sometimes. Okay, girl, you can't tell me I ain't have it this time, but keep watching. Clearly, I'm a better bling artist than I am a regular artist. I've always had, you know, a messy handwriting. Not very good at drawing, but I'm trying to give you a visual here. This is the best I could do. So we're drawing, we're gonna place those rhinestones. For example, if you had a bling lid, for example, on a tumbler, you would place those rhinestones around the lid, just like that, outline it first. And then we want to take those stones and place them directly underneath the stone. So we're not trying to fill in like the honeycomb method. So you get the picture. But then I start messing up with the different sizes of the circles and all of that. So just keep watching. But you get the point. If this were a tumbler lid or a circle, something that you were creating, you would place the stones directly underneath. I started getting a little frustrated there because, once again, it was not coming out exactly how I had expected. But I still think that someone new could get the picture. It became a disaster. I cannot draw. This next pattern, I really think that this might be one of my top favorite patterns. I'm really not a favorite type of girl because I like so many different things. But I tend to stick with the scatter method or the honeycomb method for most things that I create. I honestly think that the scatter method is easy for beginners because you're using multiple sizes. And there's really no right or wrong way to do it. You're basically just filling in those circles with different sizes of stones. So you would use 2mm, 3mm, 4mm, 5mm, 6mm. Now they try to play us with the announcements in the airport. So please disregard the last thing. But as I was saying, you're just using multiple sizes. And to me, this is easy because it really takes the guessing game out. Oh my gosh. Did I use the right size here? Did I miss a gap? Did I fill in this space? Just take all the stones and put them together closely, as close as you can. The linear method is basically you start your row of stones, and just like similar to the circular method, except you're not going in a circle, you're going to place those stones right underneath each other. You still will have a small gap in between, and so sometimes people use size 2mm to fill in those spaces. And I'll create another video on that so you can see it. I'm not really sure what that pattern is called, but it's fairly, I haven't seen it much but here lately, so I can't remember what it's called, but I'll do a video on that pattern as well. But you use a linear pattern, and then you place 2mm in between those stones. So next up, I'm going to be demonstrating on an actual piece how to do these patterns, and we'll begin by sanding our item. If I can be honest, in the past, I have not been one to sand my items all the time. When I was a bling artist, especially when I started and there was no Instagram, Facebook communities like we have today, I didn't even know I was supposed to sand stuff. And many of the things I created without sanding, they held up pretty well. I do not recommend that you don't sand at this point, because sometimes you work so hard on your creations and you do not want to get to the end of projects, give them to customers, and then stones begin to fall off. So for peace of mind, if I know that I have a project that is something that will be handled all the time, like a lip gloss that you see me doing here, a tumbler, shoes, things that people will be using all the time, I like to prep first by sanding and then wiping down with alcohol. If it were something that's just sitting on the shelf, I tend to not sand because most people will not be picking it up, handling it. And to be honest, if I could brag a little bit, crystal glaze is pretty strong, so I don't really have problems with stones falling off. Many of the tumblers that I create for myself, I do not sand them because I trust my product. And if I do have stones to fall off, I am the bling artist, so I know how to fix my own things. But I do recommend, because, you know, people are trusting you with supplying them with great quality products. Just for a peace of mind, sand your items first and wipe down with alcohol, because it will last longer, especially if you have shiny finishes like you see here. You want the rhinestones to be able to stick as best as possible and not run into any issues down the line. I made the mistake of putting a little too much glue. So generally, if that happens, you can take a toothpick or a Q-tip and smooth it out just a little bit, so you won't run into the issue of getting glue on your stones and having to go back and clean that up. But this is, I think it was a disposable eyeshadow brush that I had laying around, so I just smoothed it out with that. And here's an example of what I mean when you apply the same color rhinestones to the background. So the lid is silver, so because I'm using the crystal rhinestone, it matches. And so it gives a better outcome in the end versus if that background is silver and I apply pink rhinestones on top or purple rhinestones on top, you'll be able to see all of those gaps in the background. So to minimize the gaps that we can see, try to stick with rhinestones that are the same color of the item that you are blinging out or stressing. And so I just sped it up a little bit because, of course, it takes a little time to complete things like this. So keep watching as I go around and make this thing very sparkly and fancy. Yes, you'll see me just pushing those stones in place because we want to try to avoid the stones from moving around. The moment that the stones start to shift, that messes up the whole thing when you're doing the honeycomb pattern. So you want to make sure that the stones are as close together as possible so that you have a great outcome in the end, because it takes one stone to get off and it throws everything off, and then you'll have to use filler stones to fill in gaps, and we want to try to avoid that if possible. All right, so we have gotten pretty far and we're down to the end. And as you can see, we'll have a little space left over. And so because we cannot fit in the size that I'm currently using, which is SS20 in glass rhinestones, we're going to take some SS12 rhinestones and finish off the bottom of that lip gloss lid. If I were to use another size, we may have not run into this issue, but because I use 5mm, it just won't fit. So here we're going to use some filler stones to fill in those gaps. I'm not a perfectionist, but if you are, you should test it in advance to see what size you really want to use. I like SS20s and 5mm, so this is never an issue to me. I'm not perfect. It doesn't have to be perfect, so it doesn't bother me that at the bottom I'm using SS12. But you are the artist. Do what is best for you. All right, moving right along, because the top of this lip gloss is in a circular design, why not demonstrate the circular pattern on the lip gloss? So just as I demonstrated on the piece of paper, we're going to outline that circle with our rhinestones. Again, I'm using SS20. If you were to use a smaller stone, it would give an even different effect. This is just my preferred size. And I mentioned that in my previous video. And so we're just continuing in the circular pattern. And underneath, once we get in the middle, we're going to place those stones right underneath the ones on the first row. And once you get in the middle, you might have to shift some stones around. It does not have to be perfect. We cannot get rid of gaps. It's a part of the process. And so it will never look perfect. And so we're just continuing in a circular pattern. It's very simple. As previously stated, when we are working on projects, we want to try to match the rhinestones as closely as possible to the base of what we are working on. Here I'm going to be demonstrating the scatter method, and I'm going to be using this color rhinestone because it's close to what that base is. This is what I had at home available to me, and I'm going to be demonstrating the scatter method. If we were to continue down that tube and use the same crystal colored rhinestones, it would give a totally different effect, and we would be able to see all of that pink from the lip gloss peeking through the silver rhinestone. So it's best to try to match your rhinestones as closely as possible to your base. And I am using 2mm, 3mm, 4mm, 5mm, and 6mm. So as previously demonstrated on that sheet of paper, we're taking all of those different size rhinestones and we're just filling them in. Wherever there's a space, you pick a size and you fill in the gap. This is not going to be perfect. There is no way to avoid gaps. But you will definitely have a beautiful outcome. Just try to get them as close as possible. Okay, girl, who is this man? That is my grandfather, Dr. Samuel Richardson. He passed away in 2011, but he played a huge role in me becoming the entrepreneur that I am today. He was the president of Richardson Funeral Home, which is a business that my great-grandfather, Superintendent Alex Richardson, started. And I worked alongside my grandfather and watched my grandfather be a great businessman. So this is a frame that I have in my bling studio at home. My grandfather walked me down the field when I was in high school because I was the homecoming queen. And here I'm demonstrating the linear method. Because this is an item that I will not be handling all the time, it will just be on display. I did not sand this item. And I'm matching the color rhinestone as closely as possible to the color on the frame, which is our rose gold on Crown Crystal's website. And so, of course, I didn't finish the whole thing because it's for demonstration purposes only. But just as described on the sheet of paper, we're just going to line those stones up right underneath one another. And the final outcome will be gorgeous. Okay, girl, we did not finish the whole thing because I had work to do for Crown Crystals, but this is a rough look of how all of those methods will look or patterns. The circular method, the honeycomb method, the linear method, and the scatter methods. There's a photo of my grandfather and I. I sublimated this because I used to sublimate on a canvas.
Thank you so much for tuning in and for trusting me along your bling journey. It is my hope that you continue to add sparkle to the world. The world deserves to see your light, your art, your craft. This is really a cool craft that we have, you know. It's so unique, it's so different, and it's fancy. It's shiny, it's sparkly, it's everything that I truly love. Make sure that you like, comment, subscribe to our channel, and share it with someone else who might be starting this journey and they need a little assistance. Once you get these steps, you pretty much can bling out anything. Of course, I'll be back with more videos, more tips, but I wanted to lay the foundation first before I get into specific projects. I'm so grateful that you trust me. I'm so grateful to be in this space with you, to be a part of the bling community, and it is my desire that we continue to grow and change the world one rhinestone at a time. Bye-bye.